FAA on a continuous basis is one of the few places that this could happen to this amount of P-51. Give Lee Lauterbach a great deal of credit for getting together P-51 pilots of World War II and the P-51 from around the world. Well, this gathering in Ohio 7 years ago was a monumental event. A gathering of Mustangs and legends. Absolutely fantastic. By the way, Lee Lauterbach, the highest time P-51 pilot today. 10,000 hours of P-51 time. That's what he does for a living. He instructs them. They repair P-51s, both he and his brothers, for customers around the world. And with his instruction time of civilian and military pilots, that's how you are a contemporary pilot with 10,000 hours of P-51 time. Recently inducted into the Florida Aviation Hall of Fame, a very trusted P-51 pilot. There is the Red Tail P-51. Rise above. See, some of the aircraft are Razorback aircraft without the bubble canopy. Was on the later D models. Back to the Razorback is more efficient in terms of aerodynamic efficiency than the bubble canopy, but the bubble canopy had sideward and rearward vision, so they thought it was worth the slight reduction in speed.
Yeah, will you turn up all this memory? What? I switch back to this one, Acura, where it acts up a lot.
There is a all-gray H model. H model came out, if I remember right, after the war. They were going to build about 500, if I remember right. The war stopped, and so they stopped production as well. Very rare aircraft. Jimmy tells me that's the only one flying today. They did some great improvements on the aircraft. Well, in terms of the reputation of the B-51 against all other of the World War II fighters, was delivered by the Senate War Investigating Committee of 1944, here was their quote about the B-51, the most aerodynamically perfect pursuit plane in existence. That's great testimony to Dutch Kildenberger and all of his great designers at North American Aviation in Los Angeles, California. They were ready for the war. They already had ideas. They were just waiting for somebody to say start production. It was the British who told them that. But they gave them an edict. They said, we've got to have the airplane in 120 days. So the history books will tell that the airplane came off the assembly line in 117 days. And when asked by the reporters and people at gatherings, asked Dutch Kildenberger, how can you do that? How did you do that magic of getting that airplane out of your production, off the factory floor, and ready to be delivered in 117 days? And Dutch Kildenberger had this quote. He said, terms of magic, you cannot pull a rabbit out of a hat unless you first have a rabbit in the hat. Some people say, what do you mean by that? What he meant was he was ready. His designers were ready. All they needed was the go. Part of the key was the laminar flow wing. A relatively new design then. That kept the speed up. Initially, the aircraft wasn't mated with the correct engine, and the wings could not do what they do best. Until the Rolls-Royce Berlin engine, built in Detroit by the Packard Motor Company, Packard Motor Car Company, was put on the front of the P-51, and then it gained another 100 knots of speed, another 10,000 feet of dogfight capability, and performance and speed and agility all combined. Then that wing and that design could do what it was meant to do. Now, as the aircraft take off, I want you to look at the P-51s and look at the area on the belly. Unlike the round or radial engines, it is a liquid-cooled engine. Like the radiator on your Ford car or truck.
They are all taken up.
If that coolant is shot out, your engine will get hot, it will seize, and you have an airplane that has a glide ratio of a cement block.
That's going to be
the pilots are very careful to guard the belly of their aircraft. That's where the enemy fighter pilots would try to direct their bullets.
It's a great spot, because no one was.
Now that protrusion, that radiator on the bottom is a fair amount of drag. So here's the genius of North American Aviation. Here's how they did that. They made that radiator a jet engine, very basic jet engine. It's big in front, small in back. It has an adjustable door in back. The air heats up coming through the radiator. It goes out a smaller hole. I want you to hear this sound.
There's a whole bunch over there. Those are all the
coming out. It's a 30 degree.
now as the pilots were leaving the charge of the arena and coming back home. Daylight bombers deep into enemy territory and back. Second aircraft, the Chuck Yeager, flew the P-51, said to have a capability of approximately 500 gallons with both internal and external tanks. Drop tanks were used to be able to guard the B-24s and the B-17. And once the drop tanks were extended, they were made of pressed wood. They would jettison the drop tank, would drop to enemy territory and be of no use to the enemy because it wasn't a strategic weapon.
He said that's what the people dropped.
Mustangs looked like this, fighting with 504 gallons, 8 hours of range in the air, over 2,200 rounds of 50 caliber ammo for 6 machine guns, each shooting 850 rounds per minute. It could fight from sea level up to 39,000 feet, and that is your P-51 in front of you now.
Resort Isles will be C-47.
When you give these pilots as they pass in front of you, they will love the animation of your wings. They can't hear your flight. People from around the world flock to this location, known by many as Mecca.
Thank you.
effort. All of the expense well worth it. B-29. They built almost 4,000 of those aircraft in order to stop World War II.
Yeah. and I present to you the most feared aircraft in the world today, your United States Air Force's F-22.
Legendary P-51 Mustang dominated the skies of Western Europe after it was introduced in World War II. The P-51 Mustang is powered by a liquid-cooled, 12-cylinder Rolls-Royce Merlin engine, allowing it to achieve a range of 2,000 miles. The Super 6 aircraft had a maximum speed of 437 miles per hour and could escort heavy bombers deep into the armored journey.
Mr. Jim Beasley Jr. from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and is a founding member. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time for Mr. Jim. And approaching from the right, the F-22 Raptor and the F-35 Lightning II, flown by Major Paul Lopez and Captain Andrew Olsen.